بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنصروا الله ينصركم ويثبت أقدامكم. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: إن ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم، وإن يخذلكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعده، وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله، ألا إن نصر الله قريب. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. Respected brothers and elders, the ayat of the Quran which I recited, they speak about the nusra and the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And obviously it's heavy on the mind of every believer, the current situation that our brothers and sisters are experiencing in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them, and may Allah bring an end to the tyranny and the injustice, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve them from this suffering, and those that have passed away, grant them the highest positions in Jannah and the statuses of martyr, and those that are alive, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remedy them, heal them, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. Respected brothers and elders, when it comes to the nusrat and the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, and again, we take solace and comfort from what the Quran is telling us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that solely helps. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the ayat of the Quran which I recited, إِن يَنصُرُكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when Allah is there to help you, or if Allah helps you and aids you, then there is nobody that can overcome you. وَإِن يَخْذُلْكُمْ فَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَنصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserts a people, then there is nobody that can help other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And it is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the believers put their trust. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an example in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah At-Tawbah, when Allah ta'ala relates to us the incident of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the famous incident of the hijrah and the migration of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ. Allah Ta'ala says that if you don't help Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is and has already helped Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Ta'ala is the one that protects his deen and his religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I was there to aid Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah idh huma fil ghari idh yaqulu li sahibihi la tahzan inna Allah ma'ana. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his noble companion Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu were alone, and there was nobody there except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I helped them and I comforted them. فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ. Allah ta'ala says, I am the one that sent sakina, tranquility upon the heart of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tranquility upon the heart of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So help ultimately is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And respected brothers and elders, sometimes, subhanAllah, it seems as though that when is the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to come? And subhanAllah, the ending, the last few ayat of Surah Yusuf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after taking us through the story of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, it's not a story, it's actually a reality, but after taking us through the incident of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salatu wa salam, after relating to us the whole incident of Yusuf alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا جَاءَهُمْ نَصْرُنَا فَنُجِّيَ مَنْ نَشَاءُ وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that a time comes many a times, and this is, Allah ta'ala is not talking about ordinary people. Yes, alhamdulillah, we are people of iman. May Allah keep us firm on iman. But Allah ta'ala is talking about the prophets, the most noble, the greatest, which is Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ, that many a times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the previous Anbiya that we sent, they came to such a point whilst giving da'wah to their nation and the nation not listening to them. And not only not listening to them, but inflicting pain upon them and persecuting them. حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the prophets felt that when is the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to come? There's one narration which is mentioned in the Tafasir in Qurtubi, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says that to the extent that sometimes even the thought can cross the mind of a Nabi that where is the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا, that maybe Allah is going to withhold the help, and the help of Allah is not going to come. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا جَاءَهُمْ نَصْرُنَا, that the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes. And that's why in Surah Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when the whole of the nation is calling out that where is the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ, that the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. So the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always there, my dear respected brothers and elders. Allah is the only one that helps. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. These are the ayat of Surah Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if we help Allah, O believers, if you help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, how do we help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We cannot help Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Allah. He is our khaliq. We are His creation. We cannot help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So scholars say, إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ أَيْ إِن تَنْصُرُ دِينَهُ, that if you help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by helping the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرْكُمْ, the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you, وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ, and Allah ta'ala will strengthen and Allah will keep your feet firm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ, Allah will keep your feet firm upon deen. Qurtubi rahmatullahi alayhi also mentions under the tafsir, أي على الإسلام, Allah will keep you firm on Islam and realizing the importance of bringing deen and the value of deen within our life. Number one. Number two, وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ, Allah Ta'ala will keep your feet firm on the day of judgment. On that day when, subhanAllah, مُهْطِعِينَ مُقْنِعِي رُؤُوسِهِمْ لَا يَرْتَدُّ إِلَيْهِمْ طَرْفُهُمْ, when Allah speaks about the horrors of the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the bridge of Sirat that every person has to pass over, what Allah speaks about in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep the feet firm. So helping the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The question is that how do we help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Respected brothers and elders, we help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by bringing that deen in our life, by being regular upon the deen of Allah, by performing the salah, by fulfilling the obligations that Allah has kept compulsory or incumbent upon us, primarily which is salah, zakah, sawm, and hajj, and all the other things that Allah Ta'ala wants us to do. And honestly, subhanAllah, in tafsir Ruhul Ma'ani, under the commentary of this ayah, in yansurkum Allah, fala ghaliba lakum, if Allah helps you, Alama Alusi rahmatullahi alayh, he says that how do we draw the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the key question. How do we draw the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We draw the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing those things that please Allah. Wallahi, respected brothers and elders, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There's no way to draw the help of Allah ta'ala. And there's absolutely no way to change any condition, let alone my individual condition or your condition, or the condition of the community or the ummah at large, except with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah doesn't change the good conditions of a nation, neither does Allah change the bad conditions of a nation until they themselves don't change from within. Until they themselves don't change from within. So respected brothers and elders, the change needs to start on an individual level and then on a communal level, raising awareness about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one. Number two, my dear respected brothers and elders, we are all seeing and witnessing what is happening to our brothers and sisters. Again, may Allah make it easy for them. May Allah protect them. May Allah become their nasir. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the angels to protect them. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. My respected brothers and elders, whilst we are watching all of this, it's actually very, very important that we don't become desensitized from that which we are watching. It comes to a point within every human being, every person, that you watch so much of content until finally it comes to a point where you feel like you don't take an effect from any of these things. Respected brothers and elders, when we see the calamities that are happening, then we need to raise our hands and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, respected brothers and elders, when we look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it doesn't matter whether it was Badr, whether it was Uhud, it was Khandaq, it doesn't matter any event in the life of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether small or whether big, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam would engage his sahaba in making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So number one, extremely important that we don't become desensitized. You know, subhanAllah, the current situation with what's happening, you go to sleep, the last thing that you're looking at is what's happening. You wake up in the morning, the first thing that you are looking at is what is happening. But my dear respected brothers and elders, sometimes you need to take a step back from all of that. And we need to engage ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to engage ourselves with the Quran. If we are looking for strength, if we are looking for comfort, we will find that in the Quran. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The more that we engage with the Quran, the more we read the Quran, Allah ta'ala says, وَشِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That the Quran is a cure for the illnesses that are in your heart. It's a cure for the uneasiness, the pain, the anguish, and all of that you are going through. Allah says it's a cure for that. Recitation of the Quran will give comfort. وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Not only does it have an effect on an individual, it has an effect on the whole of society. So it will bring about tranquility from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, my dear respected brothers and elders, قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. If we want the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we need to wake up at night and perform tahajjud salah. We need to engage with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to wake up in the morning and at that time engage with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ummah of Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make dua for the ummah of Rasulullah. Cry, shed tears, my dear respected brothers and elders. Because like I said, the last thing that should happen is that, okay, 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, until finally it just goes on the back burner and everybody tends to forget and you carry on with your life. Yes, extremely important to carry on. When you look at the life of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, there wasn't a tragedy. There wasn't a day in the life of Nabi alayhi salam wherein there wasn't a tragedy. There was continuous tragedies in the life of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam, whether he was in Mecca or whether he was in Medina. The life of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, there was one hurdle, one difficulty upon another difficulty. But my dear respected brothers and elders, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam still found the strength to be able to carry on. He conducted himself. And that's why it's extremely important that we don't lose our character. It's extremely important that we don't forget and lose our own composure. And it's important that the uneasiness and the difficulty, the plight and the pain of the ummah and our brothers and sisters, it remains within our hearts and we don't become negligent of that. That's what's important. But at the same time, subhanAllah, we need to also carry on and function as normal human beings. You know, subhanAllah, sometimes you feel like as if, you know, you're seeing all of that is happening and you feel like as if you're paralyzed. You feel like as if you can't do anything. You feel demoralized. And you know what, subhanAllah, we need to draw our strength from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the scholars say that there are few, well, you know, there's many adhkar, but you know, particularly in times of difficulty, when we look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقْدِرَ فَنَادَ عَلَيْهِ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, from the depth of the ocean, from the stomach of the whale or the fish, difficulty upon difficulty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the dua of Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam was, La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu minal zalimin. This is a dua that we need to make. La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inna kunna minal zalimin. And as a result of this dua and dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we removed Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam from that difficulty. So number one, making dua and dhikr of La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inna kunna minal zalimin. Number one. Number two, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. نِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى وَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرِ. Wallahi, respected brothers and elders, this is the words that is upon the tongues of our brothers and sisters who are going through this pain and suffering. Subhanallah, they've lost everything, but you hear them say, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil, ni'mal mawla wa ni'mal nasir. Let us, when we see their pain and their suffering, let us say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And let us contemplate over these words, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And like I mentioned earlier, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Not only are these forms of dhikr, one is the aspect of dhikr and the great reward that entails for those people that will read them, but let us contemplate over what it means also. Because with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our hearts will draw strength. Our hearts will draw comfort. We will have hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without hope and mercy, in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, my dear respected brothers and elders, it becomes extremely difficult for a person to carry on. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah ta'ala grants us the strength. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us the ability to help the deen of Allah ta'ala by implementing the deen within our own lives. And also, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help our brothers and sisters that are going through the pain and the suffering, especially our brothers and sisters in Palestine. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve them of this pain and their suffering. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend upon them tranquility, sakina, وحفتهم الملائكة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower them and gather upon them the angels to protect them and look after them. And all our brothers and sisters, wherever they may be around the world, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove their pain and their suffering and shower them with His blessings. And those that have passed away, may Allah grant them maghfirah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the highest positions in Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala salah. Hayya 'ala salah. Hayya 'ala al-falah. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت والعزة والهيبة والجبروت أدب الخلائق دأب المعاشرة وندبهم إلى الملاطفة والمكاشرة. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الملك المعبود ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله الحامد المحمود صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه إلى يوم الموعود. أما بعد، فيا معشر الإخوان، علمنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم آداب المعاشرة بين العباد، منها حقوق المسلم على المسلم، فتزودوا بأدائها ليوم التناد. فمنها ألا نؤذي مسلما بفعل أو قول، فقد قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: لا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث، يلتقيان فيصد هذا ويصد هذا، وخيرهما الذي يبدأ بالسلام. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: المسلم أخو المسلم، لا يخونه ولا يكذبه ولا يخذله. كل المسلم على المسلم حرام، عرضه وماله ودمه. التقوى هاهنا، بحسب امرئ من الشر أن يحتقر أخاه المسلم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي ساعة. من يطيع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك، وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله، رضوان الله عليهم عن كل صحابة أجمعين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا، واحفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن يميننا وعن شمائلنا، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النقتان من تحتنا. رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رسولا ونبيا. عباد الله، رحمكم الله، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيذكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي الجليل يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقيموا الصفوف للصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله اثاقلتم إلى الأرض، أرضيتم بالحياة الدنيا من الآخرة، فما متاع الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة إلا قليل. إلا تنفروا يعذبكم عذابا أليما ويستبدل قوما غيركم ولا تضروه شيئا، والله على كل شيء قدير. إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا، فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا، والله عزيز حكيم. انفروا خفافا وثقالا وجاهدوا بأموالكم وأنفسكم في سبيل الله، ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
الذين آمنوا كونوا أنصار الله كما قال عيسى بن مريم للحواريين من أنصاري إلى الله؟ قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله. فآمنت طائفة من بني إسرائيل وكفرت طائفة، فأيدنا الذين آمنوا على عدوهم فأصبحوا ظاهرين. سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت، وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت، فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك، إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت. نستغفرك اللهم من جميع الذنوب والخطايا ونتوب إليك. وصلى الله على النبي الكريم. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات. اللهم ألف بين قلوبهم وأصلح ذات بينهم، وانصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم اشف مرضاهم وداوي جرحاهم واغفر لموتاهم. اللهم اجبر كسرهم. اللهم أنزل عليهم السكينة والسلوان والمغفرة والرضوان. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.